Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing my like most requested Cranberry. It's like a pinky eye look. So I'm just going to start off with just priming the eyelids, just with the normal foundation. I'm just using Estee Lauder and then just a mini beauty blender. Then I'm just going in into my Jaclyn Hill palette. I'll be naming all the colors below, but just a light burgundy orange color just in the crease, and just popping a lot of that around on the crease, and make sure you're bringing it into the inner T-ducts area. This step is crucial in creating that soft blend from the pinks. We want to make sure it's just not pink straight away. We want to have at least 3 to 4 colors. Then we're going into the Huda Beauty palette, and we're just grabbing that pink shade and popping that onto the ends and bringing that up with window wiper motions. As you can see, it takes a lot to develop the color, so just going back into the palette and going back on again. And then just grabbing my cream eyeshadow from Inglot in the shade 16 Aquatic. It's such a beautiful pink champagne kind of color, and it's great consistency, and I'm using the hell out of mine. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab the shade Turkish Delight from the Huda Beauty palette and popping that just to blend from the cream onto the burgundy shade that's matte on the ends. Then grabbing this MAC shadow, I'm not too sure which one this is, but I'll definitely pop it down below. Then grabbing the NYX matte eyeliner. I love using matte liners. This feels nice, but I feel like my ears is super, super black. A tip also, if you're not the best with liner, definitely using sticky tape on the sides of the eyes just for a cleaner kind of cut. But if you're confident and you kind of want a more oval eye, definitely just pulling up the brow will definitely make the liner step more easy, and so the liner can glide on without going clunk 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 over all those wrinkles. So just making sure you're pulling it up. Now just grabbing the Better Than Sex mascara and coating her lashes. I think it's a good step to coat the lashes before you pop the fake falsies on. Now just grabbing Taylor Beauty lashes. So these are my own line of lashes. You can purchase them in the link below. And I'm just, the style is Princess Diana. I think they're really beautiful, but they're not too long either. Then just grabbing some MAC strobe cream and popping that onto the skin. I like using the strobe cream just because it's a beautiful base. It's very hydrating, and because Estee Lauder is quite drying, I'm using the shade Cashew. Because she is spray tanned, Cashew just matches with absolutely every shade of spray tan that you can get. So I go through millions of bottles of Cashew, but I love Estee Lauder. As you can see, it doesn't really take me long to get that full coverage effect. And just using the flat side of the Real Techniques Beauty Sponge. I love this sponge. I think I've been using it since I've started. And then just going around the whole face and making sure it's even consistent throughout. Then just grabbing Rattan, it's just a lighter shade by Estee, and then kind of contouring with it, not really concealing just yet, but we'll definitely be grabbing some concealer. I love using the NARS Creamy Concealer in Vanilla to highlight. I've been using that for years, and I think it's honestly the best highlighter out there. Now using a Zoeva brush and just popping that under the eye. I just love this concealer. I think it's just the perfect kind of concealer color slash highlight color. We want to make sure that under eye is super, super bright. As you can tell, the left eye to the right eye, it just really made her eyeshadow pop and her eye color pop as well. Now just using a foundation stick by Anastasia and just using this to contour just on the cheekbones and up and around the forehead and on the other side as well. The now just using a brush and gently blending that into the foundation. This was kind of filmed probably a year ago actually. I don't contour as strong now, but definitely looking back at this, I'm like, wow, am I crazy with the contour? But you know what, at the end of the day, the look comes together at the end, but now I don't usually use that as much, but it's still gorgeous and you can still go back in and erase the contour just with some foundation, as you will see in the clip earlier. So as you can see, I'm just going back in and blending. There's so much blending involved. I think my right hand and my left hand both have gained so many muscles just by blending. Then just grabbing my MAC NC40 and just popping that on the skin, just using a flat brush. I love this powder. I think I've used the hell out of it, and it saves my life every time. So after watching back on this video, I just realized I had sunnies on my head the whole entire time of doing Anastasia's makeup. Oh my god. Oh, what am I doing with my life? Now grabbing that shade Saffron and popping that under the eyes just to blend now the whole eyeshadow look together. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that she's nice and bronzed. So I'm using the Hourglass bronzer. I love this bronzer. It's not too strong and it's also got like a shimmer onto it. And I think it's just gorgeous. Just gives her some glow as well. It's not just so matte on the face. Then grabbing my Emrizy and Anastasia highlighter and using just a small fluffy brush and applying that on the highest points of the face. So it's just on the cheekbones, on the nose, on the lip, and also on the chin. Then to enhance the highlight, I like to go in with the Artist Couture Illuminati. It honestly just makes the eyeshadow, the highlighting pop so much. Then I like to go in with my brow pomade and also my brow powder. I like to use the powder just first, and that's just by Anastasia. And I just used a medium brown color to pop that on. Now I'm using the Guard lip line. I'm not too sure what the shade is. It's just like a nudie pink kind of color, just to line her lips just before I pop the lipstick on. Now just coating her lips with the Huda Beauty strobe liquid lipstick. I love this lipstick. And then now just coating her bottom lashes yet again with the mascara, and then just brushing her brows, and we are all done. Finished look. Put some setting spray if you like. I honestly really don't believe in it, but I still think it's great. Set the face and you're all ready to go. Hope you guys enjoyed. Love yous. Bye.